you know what it is like for somebody to be highly drafted, third round, but 85th overall out of the Big 12 and placed in Cleveland, Ohio as the hope and of a franchise there. Do you have any two cents on Baker Mayfield and the sort of difficulty he sometimes gets from folks in Cleveland about not doing enough and things of that nature, just putting yourself back in the shoes of 2010, 2011, and things of that nature?
Yeah. Colt? Yeah, well, I'll tell you this. I always have the backs of quarterbacks, especially those guys who play in Cleveland. The fans in Cleveland are amazing. All they want is to win. And, you know, I think over the last few years, they've done a great job. I mean, they won a playoff game last year. So I know in my time in Cleveland, I gave it absolutely everything I had, and it just didn't work for a lot of different reasons. But there wasn't anybody there that wanted it more and wanted to see it work. So I think Baker's done a great job. Again, I'll take the quarterbacks back all the time, because playing this position in this league against these defenses week to week, you know, and for Baker's sake, playing in the AFC North, it's tough. So I don't know what that means. I just know that, you know, I enjoyed my time in Cleveland. We just didn't win. And when you don't win in this league, you get replaced. And, you know, I learned that lesson the hard way. And glad to be where I'm at right now.
Yeah,
sure.
Year 11, Colt, for you, franchise five, year 11. If I had told you on that draft night you'd play 11 years in the NFL, what would you say? What would you have said to me?
I did not know what, you know, at that point when I was coming out of college, I didn't know if I was going to get to play again because of the injury that I took in the national championship against Alabama. I mean, doctors couldn't tell anybody when I was going to be ready to play, if I was going to be able to throw again, all those things. So I had to live through that nightmare for a little bit. But, you know, once I got into the league, I realized real quickly that this is not college anymore, and this is, you've got to figure out how to play this game like a pro.
And what was that challenge? Seriously, now that you're looking back on it, you hear all the conversations going on in the NFL right now about this guy should start, that guy should start. I guess we're kind of all through that for 2021 with all the starting quarterbacks. And, you know, there was another kid across the way from you yesterday in Trey Lance waiting for his chance when that comes for San Francisco. What is the now you look back with 2020 vision of 11 NFL years for that?
Well, I think that for any young quarterback that comes into the NFL, you know, you were generally the best player on the field wherever you played in college, whether that was, you know, high level college or whether it was that, like, you know, for Trey Lance at a smaller school. And so you would go into games knowing you were the best player and making a bunch of plays. And when you come into the NFL, I mean, this is the best of the best. You know, every team, you know, the teams that have losing records right now have great players, and they're usually, you know, one fumble away or one ball bouncing the other way away from having a winning record. And guys are they're just good. You can't run around guys anymore. Lamar Jackson can. Kyler Murray can. I can't. So you got to figure out how to play in the pocket, how to switch protections, how to read defenses, where the ball is supposed to go versus different coverages. You know, that is a huge learning curve. And, you know, fortunately, I worked really hard and I'm still able to get to play this kid's game that I really love. But it takes a lot of work and a lot of energy and a lot of effort and a lot of time to really kind of figure that out.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.